it's also important for us as men to think about what makes the woman whole. Like, just think about what make them feel confident and feel purposeful, feel needed, feel like they doing some shit that, you know what I'm saying? It's important. And I never really, like, we, especially as a young nigga, man, you know what I'm saying? We be so intent on building, doing, and having it our way. We don't even be thinking about what the next motherfucker might experience or how the next motherfucker might feel.
Oh, God.
So it's important for us to do that. And I ain't really see that shit until I had a daughter. Like, I started to see what women go through when my daughter would come to me and be like, yeah, but man, that ain't fair because you don't do them like that. I'm like, huh, yeah, you're right. I don't. But it's different. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's different. And it's hard to explain that, but that is a battle that women fight from birth, fighting to be treated equally as men.
I feel like it's because, goddamn, like, daughters don't really carry on the legacy like sons do.
Mm.
They often married into another legacy.
But it's more to a legacy than just a name, though. You got principles. You got morals. You got... And to be honest with you, the daughters stick to the code
more than the sons.
Because when the son meet the wife gonna goddamn... dictate and determine how that shit move forward for the most part.
And then when the woman meet the husband gonna dictate too, because he
man,
gonna take
not
a
really,
position
man, for real,
of leadership.
Most of the time, the women run the show. Most of the time, I give you an example. Let's just say if I get old, right? I get old in the same position as my daddy was, where I got Alzheimer's or dementia, something like that, where I can't take care of myself, right? If I go to my son's house, and his wife say, man, it's too much. He got to go. We got to put him in a home. I'm gone. If I go to my daughter's house and her husband say, she gonna say, hell no, he gonna goddamn set this hospital bed up right in the motherfucking living room. You goddamn, you know. It's pros and cons to both sides.
I feel like it's 50-50 though, when it comes to that. Because the son got to say so too.
Happy wife, happy life. That's what that shit, you know what I mean? So ultimately, okay, if y'all have a breakdown in communication, she feel one way, you feel another way, it gonna be decided by the pussy. It gonna be like, all right, well, you ain't get no pussy then, nigga. All right, cool. No pussy for you. Now what? And you're like, man, god damn, pops, you got to go, man. Like, for real, that really the way that shit gonna goddamn boil down. And 95% of the time, this how it's gonna happen. The women control that shit with the pussy.
I feel like as a man, I'm just naturally more overprotective of my daughter than I am of my sons.
Bro. That's also true. This is also true.
I don't know why. I don't know what it is, but I feel like it's because as men, we know how we do women.
Because sons can't get pregnant.
That too, but it's like...
sons can't get pregnant.
But we know how we treat women. So I feel like I just don't want my daughter to ever just run into one of them niggas.
But you can't keep her from running in the
nah, world. You can't keep her, but I want her to know how to feel real love so that she know how to discern what's the difference between
right.
the two.
Yeah, see
what I'm saying?
Absolutely. I think that's key. That's key. Being able to motherfucking provide the, you know what, me and Lil Duval call it thought prevention hours. You got to put in them thought prevention hours. Keep your daughter off the pole. You know what I'm saying? So you spending time going to daddy-daughter dances and you taking them on trips with just you and her. Those are thought prevention hours that you're putting in. You got to do that. Yeah, don't do that. But hey, going to be somewhere in Magic City, man. You know what I'm saying? Trying to figure it out.
Yeah.
So that is absolutely necessary for any father. If you ain't putting in your thought prevention hour, then your daughter end up a down. So don't blame her now. Don't look at her talk about, oh, you motherfucking hot ass. No, nigga, you didn't set an example. You did not set an example. You did not show what the fuck it was that she should be doing versus what she's doing.
Right.
So I think, you know what I mean? That has a huge, but I see
Man. I feel like mothers are more overprotective of daughters too than sons.
Yeah, I think it's definitely across the board.